Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you a quick and effective way to replace a burnt out sky in a photo. This is an update of a tutorial I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. Open a photo with a sky you'd like to replace. If you'd like to use this one, I provided its link in my video's description or project files below. The first step is to separate the sky from the rest of the photo. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, I'll use the Quick Selection tool. If you're using this tool as well, I generally find a radius of 5 to 15 pixels works fine. Drag the tool over your landscape to select it. To remove the selection on the sky, press and hold Alt on Windows or Option on a Mac as you drag your tool over those areas. To check your selection to make sure it included all of your landscape, press Q on your keyboard to change the selection into a quick mask. We'll refine the edges in a moment. Press Q again to revert it back into a selection. At the top, click the Select and Mask button if you're using version 2015.5 or later, or if you're using an earlier version, click the Refine Edge button. You could also go to Select and click Select and Mask or Refine Edge in this list. I did in-depth tutorials on Refine Edge and Select and Mask, so if you'd like to watch them, I included their links as well. Click Smart Radius and drag the radius a bit to the right. If you want to make your tool bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Drag the tool over the edges of your landscape to refine their edges. Check Decontaminate Colors, which removes color fringe of the sky that may bleed into our landscape. Output it to New Layer with Layer Mask, then click OK. Make the background visible and make the top layer active. Open your Gradient tool. Make sure the Linear Gradient icon is active and click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click the black-white preset and click the lower left stop. Click the color box and in the hexadecimal field type in 0151FE. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the lower right stop and the color box. Type in A7CAFF. Then press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Place your cursor a little above halfway up the sky and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient tool a little above the horizon. Then release. You'll notice that the gradient colors are inside your landscape instead of behind it, so we need to invert the layer mask. To do this, make the layer mask active and press Ctrl or Command I. Make a copy of the top layer and its layer mask by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click off the chain link to unlink the layer and the layer mask. Doing this allows us to resize and reposition either of them independently of the other. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Go to Filter, Render, and Clouds. Change its blend mode to Screen. Zoom out of your image by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard a few times. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to a top corner and drag the Transform tool out approximately this much. To accept it, click the check mark at the top. To fit your image back onto your canvas, press Control or Command 0. The clouds actually extend beyond the visible area of our canvas, so we need to crop them off. To do this, press Control or Command A to select the visible area of our document, and go to Image and Crop. To deselect it, press Control or Command D. Open your Transform tool and go to the bottom of the Transform's bounding box. When you see a vertical double arrow, drag it up to the bottom of the sky. Then press Enter or Return. Lastly, we're going to make our clouds a little less feathery and the blue sky a bit more vibrant. Double-click the thumbnail of the clouds to open its layer style window. The Blend If feature essentially clips one layer into the other based on the tones of the active layer and the layer below it. The slider of this layer is always linked to the active layer. In this case, our active layer is the clouds. Our gradient color is the underlying layer. Place your cursor directly on the icon on the slider of this layer and Alt-click or Option-click it. This splits the icon in two. By dragging the right half of the icon to the right, it feathers out the clouds over the darkest areas of the gradient color, thereby revealing more of the color and less of the clouds in those areas. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!